distractions, and noise. They are everywhere and never ending. All day, phones, email, the internet, social media, they beep and buzz demanding our attention. We have become so ingrained in technology, we don't realize the toll it takes on us. But it diminishes and drowns out what matters most in our lives, connecting with God and people.
What's up, strong family? We are here, week three. You are doing so good. Let's take a deep breath together. We've done this. We're with Dr. David. Dr. David's our coach for Connect. Now, Dr. David is a national leader when it comes to helping people connect, but also historian and teacher of the mission of the YMCA. Yeah. And so, Dr. David, you know, I look at my life right now, especially during the pandemic. I'm scrolling more than I ever have. I'm binge watching TV more than I ever have. Yeah. I am, you know, the news media and political. I'm just, I'm in this world where I feel like I'm connecting.
Yes.
Yet I feel so broken and alone and tired from doing this. So talk to us through, what does it mean to truly connect?
Yes. And the point that you just brought up, Jeff, is so profound, that there is this crazy contradiction in our culture right now, where all the research is actually saying that we are more superficially connected than we've ever been. Everybody's on social media. You have 1,000 friends on Facebook. You have Instagram followers. Everyone is superficially connected. And yet, the research is saying that we are the most lonely, disconnected generation in the history of the world. People feel more disconnected now than ever. And so let me just offer a few things for how to connect in the midst of our crazy world. First of all, we love being a part of the YMCA, and I hope you know this, but the YMCA is not just a gym and swim, but it is meant to be the hub of connection. Goal of the YMCA is, we want to connect you. So I challenge you, get connected in and through your YMCA. Second, I challenge you that this would be a week where you connect deeper with the relationships in your life that are most meaningful to you. Pick one night this week and make it absolutely screen free. No texts, no emails, no social media. Be all in and fully there for your family or for your friends. Okay, and then here's a third thing. Not only your YMCA, not only with relationships of those in your life, but the YMCA has always been about connecting people to their spirit, minds, and bodies. And just to be honest with you, I want to tell you about the deepest connection in my life, okay? My power source of hope and joy and meaning and purpose is when I connect with God. And so I like to get out in the woods and walk by myself and pray and deepen my connection with God. And I just want to challenge you this week. Maybe you need to get out in nature. Maybe you need to do whatever it is you do for your heart to be fully alive, and try to connect your spirit, your mind, and your body.
That is some good challenges. My wife is going to love you for the second one, that I need to be more present, because that is so true. Put the phone down and be present with her. Gosh, Dr. David, I want you to see, this is the vintage YT shirt.
I noticed
it. What do you think of this shirt?
I love it. I want one. And let me just close it out with a short vintage story. I don't know if you know this, but the YMCA started in the 1840s, in a time where England was like disconnected. People were overworked, exhausted, and a group of people got together and said, "We're forming a strong group. We're going to be connected to each other." And 12 people actually got together, encouraged each other, prayed together, and said, "We will form a strong group. We'll find connection in the midst of these crazy times. We're part of a story that's been going for a long, long time."
That is so cool. Well, I can't thank you enough for being here. Here's a challenge. Find two opportunities this week to look at your tracker and mark times that you are going to connect. I really like the idea of the no screen night, so let's see if we can all do that one. Dr. David, thank you so much for being my friend, being a friend of the YMCA. Let's connect a little more today. I look forward to that, and have a great week, guys. Connect.